Information, inspiration, motivation, conscientisation et surtout distraction. Gardez tout votre pot pourri avec Flore, votre Flore, tous les samedis, 6h, 7h. Gardez tout la radio pour réfléchir.
Joseph Surgery, Dr. Roman Joseph, et nous au cœur de North Shore. C'est une clinique qui est très accessible parce que l'époque nous avons pris le bus Serge Miami, quoi que bus 2, bus 9, bus 10, toute zone ça a fait zone 1. Et puis c'est une clinique qui desservit tout le monde, que ce soit où habiter dans North Shore, que ce soit dans Little Haiti, notre Miami. Moi, je recommande une clinique Roman Joseph parce que moi-même, moi, je suis ancien patient. Adresse Dr. Roman Joseph, c'est 94-15 Nord 10 6e Avenue. 94-15 Nord 10 6e Avenue.
Là, au cas chauffé, au cas tout, il y a n'importe quelle température. Il faut juste passer sous poumon, comme ça, de façon à ce que vous capable ouais en bas poumon qui s'arrive. C'est ça que nous utilisons pour nous capable faire un sonogramme. Sonogramme là, ça c'est un petit appareil qui la donne, qui permet que gagne un bagage que le voyez. Qui permet que dans l'écran, nous sommes capables de voir en bas pour un qui ça qui gagne. Un sonogramme pas gagne douleur la donne. Fait un mammogramme, le peser TT1, il n'est pas obligé de faire mal. Cherchez qu'on est à l'écoute, il est capable de faire pour vous sans que il n'y ait pas de douleur. Ça.
Mais il y a une raison qui fait que nous encourageons tout le monde à venir, c'est parce que nous-mêmes, nous prenons nous pour nous capables d'expliquer mon yoleur au venir. Qui ça a gagné?
Adresse Dr. Roman Joseph, c'est 94-15 Nord 10 6e Avenue. 94-15 Nord 10 6e Avenue.
Téléphone-nous dans Joseph Surgery, c'est 786-401-6455. 786-401-6455.
94-15 Nord 10 6e Avenue. 94-15 Nord 10 6e Avenue.
This show is brought to you by Jeff Hess, attorney at law. 305-255-2797. Ça, c'est avocat PAM. Jeff Hess, spécialisé dans accident machine. Ou glissé ou tombé dans la rue, dans maquette, avocat bourré les couignés là, c'est Jeff Hess. 305-255-2797. Jeff, también habla espagnol. 305-255-2797. Casas et Jeff, ma pralerie les couilles là, 305-255-2797.
Sorti jeudi à même, voyez minute.com by famille ou des amis qui en Haïti pour être capable de jouer un pile bonus valable pour 7 jours. Toute recharge sorti pour PPT $5 et après c'est internet illimité avec 50 minutes pour les États-Unis et Canada. Et puis, si vous top up pour PPT $7, laissez-y après c'est internet illimité à 80 minutes pour les États-Unis et Canada. Pour causer à même, les top up pour PPT $10, y a recevoir bonus internet illimité avec 200 minutes gratis pour les États-Unis et Canada. Tout avantage ça est valable pour 7 jours seulement. Prends un petit temps pour vous top up by poche en Haïti, comme ça vous êtes capable de faire quelque content et vous êtes capable de jouer de tout avantage dans comme vous.
Une communauté qui progresse est une communauté en santé. Et pour nous parler de santé, Hosanna College of Health, c'est l'école par là même. Côté au capable vini yon PN dans un an, LPN ou ka vini AN dans un an, et si ou AN déjà, ou capable gagner BSN ou dans un an. Dans Hosanna College, tout professeur yon expérimenté. Salle de classe yon pas chargée, yon bien équipé. Horaire classe yon très flexible. Avec des sessions les matins, les après-midi, les soirs et même les week-ends. Visitez Hosanna College of Health, qui est dans 6151 Miramar Parkway, suite 300. Relais dans 954-544-3065. 954-544-3065.
Et bien c'est ça, ou toujours sous émission parlant, Radio TV avec Dr Flore. 305-541-2365, 305-541-2365, si vous voulez dire mon petit bonsoir, eh bien fait ça. Et puis, relim, et dans le cas contraire, merci nous-mêmes, Cap Gadeno, sous 1080 AM, eh bien sous télévision tous les jeudis, 11.3 Haïti TV, tous les lundis à 9h30 sous Island TV. Ça nous pas perdre du temps, n'a salué Pedro Gassan. Eh bien, c'est toujours plaisir nous pour nous baptiser avocat. Ça me cabaye tête moins crédit. Me capable après, mais quand même, yo toujours baptisé sur Radio TV avec Dr Flore. What a pleasure for me to have you, Pedro, here as a representative of the Haitian American, Haitian Lawyers Association. Tell us a little bit briefly about you. Why have you decided to join such prestigious organization?
Well, first off, I want to thank you, Dr. Flore, for having me on your wonderful program. It is a true honor to be here. You know, being involved in the Haitian Lawyers Association for me is extraordinarily important, particularly when you think about all of the issues that are impacting our community. You think about TPS and the issues that are surrounding us, and you have to be involved within what's going on in the community. I was born and raised here in Miami. My parents are both from Haiti, and I went to law school in an attempt to say, you know what, I want to be able to understand what goes on with respect to the law and how it has an impact on people. And today, what I do is I practice in the area of real estate law, and my work has a tangible impact on people every single day. And what I wanted to do was to be able to give back to the community, so I joined the Haitian Lawyers Association. And what it does for me is it allows me to have a core connection to my community, to have a core connection to our constituents, and particularly when you think about TPS and the expiration that's coming up on July 22nd, 2019, it's very, very important for us to come together, to stand in solidarity, and to make a commitment to be unified against the people and against actions that are having a negative impact on our community.
Eh bien, c'est ça, Pedro Gassan, son jeune avocat, qui lui-même c'est yon connaît dans affaire real estate. Avait dit que ou même qui gen kay kap krasé, kay qui voulait louer, qui voulait acheter kay, Pedro Gassan, c'est avocat pour là. You can give the number of your office quickly. That's my gift to you.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Flore. It's 305-789-7430. What I do is I actually help developers when they're acquiring land, when you're selling land, and being able to maximize the profits off the land, because what we do is we engage in helping to advise our clients as to how to maximize the profits on their land and their acquisitions.
Eh bien, c'est ça, nous-mêmes qui gros autobré, qui gagne un gros projet, qui gagne et construction là-dedans, qui gagne terre, eh bien, c'est petite garçon communauté en Pedro Gassan que nous recommandons. Pedro, let's go straight to the gala. HLA is celebrating how many years?
It's our 20th anniversary. It's going to be at the Rusty Pelican on March 24th at 7 p.m. One of the things that I love about the gala is that we also give three scholarships to young law students, and it's really a mechanism by which we help to ensure that law students can continue down the path of being able to pass the bar, become practicing attorneys, so that they can give back to the community and have a tremendous impact on our people.
Yes, but what is the protocol for you to really give those scholarships? Do they have to compete, write an essay, or just out of the blue they apply and they get it? Because for three people to get it every year, what is the protocol, as
so,
I
so,
ask?
So the protocol is there's an application process, there's an essay, there's a resume. We evaluate the essay, we evaluate the resume of the applicants, we evaluate how they're doing in law school, and then we make a determination as to the written quality of their work, with respect to the essays, the quality of their resume, the credentials that they have, and along with their application, and make a determination as to who are the three most fitting for the scholarships, because it is a sort of staple recognition within the community to be able to provide them with the ability to have the scholarship and to be able to say that these are the three within the South Florida community who are really doing a stellar job within law school, and we want to be able to recognize them at the gala.
Those scholars, once they graduate, do they give back to HLA? How do you feel that your scholarship pays the purpose?
So they actually do. We actually have a the president-elect, the president who's going to be after me, is Altanise. And Altanise had been a former scholarship recipient. And mm-hmm. one of the things that we want to do is make sure that the scholarship recipients are part of a pipeline. Mm-hmm. Individuals who, while they're in law school, they're involved. And then when they graduate and they pass the bar, they become involved within the community. Because the idea is you can't get all the education and hold it to yourself. You have mm-hmm. to get the education and give it back to the community. And that's one of the things that we want to make sure. And Altanise is an excellent example of doing that, of being able to receive the scholarship, pass the bar, start practicing law, and then join HLA, and has a very strong impact on what we're doing on an everyday basis.
You know, for 20 years, I miss only one gala. I'm a great supporter of HLA. From Marie-Jo Toussaint, let me see if I know your presidents. I'm giving myself my legal test. Marie-Jo Toussaint, people that you may mm-hmm. get to know now. Beatrice Cazot, Kurt Conzi as mm-hmm. president. After that, they had Richard Champagne. They had Ronald Surin. They had Stéphanie Duchesne. Mm-hmm. And followed by Doty Joseph. Mm-hmm. And after Doty, they had Patricia Elize. You see all the money I gave to HLA, followed by now Lodi Jean. And the president served for 2 years.
No, so
you 1 year.
It's a 1 year term. What happens is you become the president-elect, and it's essentially a transition term.
Okay.
You spend a year, essentially I've been dovetailing Lodi for the entire year, learning what she does, learning the presidency. And then now, starting on March 24th, I'll become the president, and I'll have a year term, and then Altanise will follow after me.
Excellent. Then what should people expect besides the scholarship keynote speaker? Mm-hmm. Would you have a keynote speaker that will really convey a special message that will relate with your topic, your term for the year?
Absolutely. So the keynote speaker this year is Al Jacquet.
From Broward, yes.
State Representative. And one of the things that the core theme for our gala this year is standing in solidarity. And I don't think that we could have picked a better phrase and a better theme, because at the end of the day, everything that we've ever done as a community that has had an impact, that has had a positive impact on what we've done and our legacy, has been when we've stand together. Mm-hmm. And I expect that Representative Jacquet will spend a significant amount of time focusing on that importance, the importance of being able to say that we're standing together in solidarity, mm-hmm. the way that Dr. Flo stands in solidarity with the Haitian Lawyers Association, and as you do with the entire Haitian community and the Haitian diaspora. So
I think it's a great choice, a much better choice than Gracelle Beauvais that you had 1 year. Don't worry, I'm the media. The media is the one that critiques. But let me tell you why I say it's a great choice. Al Jacquet has done some work also in Tallahassee as it relates to bringing the Caribbean the Caribbean culture, mm-hmm. and also when it comes to having HLA doing what you call the clinics. You know, you have done it in Broward, you have done it in Dade, and I need to commend from Patricia and Lodi the balance that you guys are keeping between the counties.
Absolutely. We've made it an important emphasis for ourselves to mm-hmm. say, you know, we're not just going to be focused on Miami-Dade.
You grew up, guys.
We've grown, and it's a matter of cultivating that relationship. So, you know, we have a strong Haitian population in Miami-Dade, in Broward, and Palm Beach, and we want to be able to make sure that each member of the community has access to the services that we provide.
You said it's going to be at the Rusty Pelican, March 24th. And any band playing besides the we went to the content, mm-hmm. we went to the format, but about the entertainment.
Absolutely. So it's going to be hosted by Success Junior, and it's going to have Impossible that's going to go and perform, and it's going to be the main sort of attraction for the entertainment.
Ah, okay. Then no point jazz jeune. That's kind of cool. Okay, I like that. And where do people get their tickets, or if they cannot come, the website where they can donate to support HLA?
Absolutely. So it's the Haitian Lawyers Association Haitian Lawyers Association.org. You can buy your tickets online. You can donate to the organization if you want to. And that's going to be the main source that you can obtain your tickets. If for whatever reason you're unable to access that website, or if you want to contact me directly, feel free to contact me at Pedro, P-E-D-R-O, dot Gassant, G-A-S-S-A-N-T, at hklaw.com, and I'll be more than happy to guide you through the process to make sure that you can attend this wonderful event.
Okay, it was a pleasure to have you. Keep up the good job.
Thank you so much.
Bonsoir, ça nous live là, Radio TV avec Dr. Flo, c'est une surprise. Juste un peu de mots, nous finissons jouer spot là. Nous comptons 17 mars, c'est une date importante pour firme Hudson Robia. Dis-nous à public là, qui ça pour public là attend.
Oh, Dr. Flo, bon, merci en ville pour appel là, pour dire c'est une surprise. Mais quand même, son magasin a préparé quelques jours, nous vraiment content et de continuer de partager avec le public là, en commençant à nous les saluer.